Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, it all went a bit wrong. And that's why I'm having to record my intro at a later date, because we had power cuts, we had accidents, whatever went wrong could go wrong. I'll just briefly tell you what we do in this video. Basically, we do some gorgeous Russian almond shaped nails with some glitter and some one stroke nail art. So I've just fitted the sculpting forms for these two nails. We're going to match these nails with the design on this hand. So I've dehydrated the nail. I've already removed the surface shine before that. So we have actually taken off a set of nails on the lovely Andrea. So if you can see the colours that we're going for, it's like a blue, purple and green. Oh my God, that bit of green just makes it go boom and pops beautifully. And they're the colours we're going to continue working with. One of the nails is going to be completely warm beige. We're going to do some one stroke on that. The other one will have a little bit of the glitter in and a small amount of one stroke on. So I can show you two different ways of doing the one stroke on your nail design. So I pick up a bead, sculpt out the Russian almond shape. One nice big bead to get the bulk of the structure down. And then I can build up the apex after that with another bead. Just smooth it all out. Make sure your brush is damp while you're doing this. It'll make it a lot smoother. Tidy up the edges, make sure it's nice and sharp. And then with this one, you'll probably think, what are you doing here? Because you're doing this a bit different. So I've got a smaller bead, created the free edge. Then I'm going to the back part by the cuticle, leaving a gap. I'm leaving a gap because I'm going to add a little bit of gorgeous glitter in there. So I've got a mixture of the glitters that we've been using in this video. And I'm just feeding them into that gap and then encapsulating those with some clear. Look at all that glitter. Oh my God, could I fit any more glitter into that gap? Mind the gap. So yeah, it's all encapsulated now. So you can file it. Because if you didn't put any clear acrylic on, you wouldn't be able to file it, would you? You wouldn't have no strength. Here we go, we're gonna file these bad boys now, get them all into shape, perfect it. Make sure that pinch is nice. It wasn't ready to come off the form, so I can go back to that nail, finish that one, and then I can check the other nail afterwards to check that that can come off the form. And this is generally what I do when I'm doing a full set. I work from one finger to another. I'm going to buff over this nail, make it nice and smooth.
Right, so we're going to use some polycolour paints. We're going to work with the colours that we have got on the nails. I'm not entirely sure how many of these colours I'm going to use. Did I just get them all out? How about that? I do know I want to mix like a green that's like more of a lime green. I don't have one of them. So I'm going to mix that with a little bit of sap green and brilliant yellow. Oh, it's brilliant. I'm going to use quite an old brush to mix that with. If you drag your brush across, it'll flatten it out and it'll really spread it so you know it's fully mixed. I've got navy blue, violet, which is really dark. I've got brilliant violet and lilac. I've got a one stroke brush. I'm going to prep that by putting it into the water and then pulling it. So go into the water and pull it along the tissue so it's slightly damp. Then I'm going to go into navy. Then I'm going to go into that lime green. I'm going to drag both sides, blending the colour into the brush. I'm going to use the brush quite flat. And the beauty of one stroke is you can go back over, you can correct anything. And it'll also give it a deeper colour. So we're going to do a few of these shapes with this colour and then we're going to move to the lilacs. I'm going to reload as I go. As I see the paint running out and drying out, I will reload. I'm going to layer them over each other as well to make sure that each layer is dry before you go over the top, else you will make a mess. Rinse the brush. I'm rinsing it because it's starting to dry in the brush. I'm going to get it nice and clean again and I can work with the paint again. I'm going to use this colour on the other nail as well. So still using the navy and green combination. Doing everything a little bit smaller. Now I'm going to change the colour. I'm going to go into the dark purple, into the lilac. We have got some tutorials just on the different angles that you can create when you're doing one stroke, you want to check that out. And I'm going to add some small ones onto this nail as well, just some small little petal-like shapes. I'm just going to add some fine, tiny little dots as if they are little pollen sort of thing. Just pollen. Is that what it is? Nectar?
No.
What's nectar? Is that not to do with pollen?
Not pollen.
Yeah. I'm just going to do a vine. Just using a detailing brush. It needs to have a little bit of length on so you can glide over the nail. What I'm going to do now is seal that in. So I'm going to use the Urban Graffiti top coat. Now this is a clever little trick to make your paint last longer. Do a thin coat of the Urban Graffiti top coat and cure it for 20 seconds. And then bring it back out and do a full repaint, full cure. Because it's not fully set and it's still a little bit tacky, it actually adheres to each other better and just makes it last longer. So second coat, and when you put it in this time, you're going to do a full cure. I'm going to finish those two off with cuticle oil. This is the lemon cuticle oil. Let's rub that in. And I think you'll agree that those colours really complement each other and it looks really cool on the full set. I especially like this one. This is my favourite one. Because you've got lots of glitter sparkly and then you've got it surrounded by those flowers. There you are, guys. That's how I combined a bit of one stroke with a bit of glitter, all encapsulated on a full look. I hope you've enjoyed that video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. And all the products that I've used today in this video will be listed below. I'll see you in the next video. Keep watching. Bye-bye.